Hello and welcome back, Highlevelers. Rio Daniel here. And in this video, what I want to go over is a new feature release that Highlevel has gone through relating to QR codes. Now, this isn't like super exciting. People have heard of QR codes and you might already have your favorite QR code generator, but I can tell you what, it really does get to be a pain when you're having to use a third-party QR code generator. And then they've got some tools that aren't available on the free plan. And then you have another expense to generate more QR codes for a particular customer. And then maybe you have to generate those QR codes for your customer and you have to keep doing it as they need it. And wouldn't it be nice to just have the QR code generation feature built into Highlevel where your clients can go run and do all of this stuff for themselves, create all of these different QR codes for whatever purposes that they have? Yes, that would be fantastic. That would be excellent. So right now, I just want to show you, it's not going to be a long video. Just want to show you some of the features that are now available. And one of the kind of freaky things that I found out regarding the QR codes with Highlevel. Let me show you. Okay, so here we are inside of just a regular account. And what I want to show you is there are actually two places inside of Highlevel where you can generate QR codes. Now, this is strange because I'm thinking to myself, why would you want to have your QR codes in two different places? Anyway, I'm just going to show you and then I'm going to focus on one particular area. So the very first one that we're going to take a look at here is actually built inside of the reputation area. So if you go to reputations and go to settings, a menu option right here, this is where you would access your review AI. If you have it turned on for that particular client to do auto responses and things like that. If you come over here, notice that there's a review QRs. If you just click on it and then here that there's already one here, I'm going to go ahead and just delete that one. But this is where you have one possibility of creating QR codes. Now, the problem here is that this area inside of the reputation is only available for creating reviews QR codes. So let's just take a quick look. If we click on create, we get this kind of editor. We already get this pre-built area where we have a text box. We have a couple of images for Facebook or Google, which I don't really quite understand because typically you can only have one URL kind of programmed for this particular QR code. But the one thing about this is that you don't have to specify in this area your Google review link. Why is that? Because if you already have your integrations with Google My Business, the Google review link has already been generated and this link will go directly to that Google review generation. So just to give you a heads up, this is one of the things that's a little bit different than the other place, what I would consider to be the primary place where people would be creating their QR codes. And I'll show you that in just a minute. But notice over here, we have elements very similar to a website designer. If you wanted to drop another QR code or another image, text, just simply drag and so forth and bring it over. Now, I'm not going to be designing anything in this particular area. But you're going to see what I mean. This right here is where you can upload from the media library. You can put in a URL here, but notice if you click on the QR code that already comes as default, there is no property settings for being able to do this. So right now you can customize this and put in whatever text you want, put in your logo or remove your logo if you want to here. So we'll go ahead and just remove that. And you should be able to just click delete. I wasn't really thinking about that, but it doesn't look like it's very cooperative with being able to actually delete these images or move the images off the screen here. So that's definitely a bug there. So yeah, that's definitely something I would have to keep in mind of just not being able to remove the image once you put it on here. So anyway, this is an area I thought was just weird because what I want to do is not focus on this area. And I really just want to focus on the main area, which is under sites. And then there's this new menu option here at the top, as we see for new, called QR codes. So this is where we can do a bunch of different things if we wanted to. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on QR codes. Now, the interface here is a bit different. So right now we're going to do just a create new. You can do either one of them. And here's where now we get to choose. We get to give it a name here. We'll just do review QR1 in case we want to do multiple of these. But here's where we get to simply choose. Now, here's where we sit back and have to look at the website. We could choose. Keep in mind, a QR code, if you're not familiar with it, I should have mentioned it, is just a visual way of representing a URL. That's it. So you scan a particular QR code with your phone's camera. The camera will recognize the QR code, decipher the URL, and then open up that page, making it easier. You've probably seen this if you ever went to restaurants that have moved away from menus, and now they just have QR codes stuck to the table where you scan the QR code and open it up and look at the menu on your phone. Anyway, that's where we can put in a website. And the benefit of this is that website could be anything. It could be your personal blog site. It could be your YouTube channel, your LinkedIn profile. You could really create a QR code for anything. But what I find very useful, at least about this tool, is that you don't have to go to a third party. I can't tell you how annoying it's been having to send people and have people go do things with a third party, try to create a QR code. And one of the main reasons why you would want to create QR codes is, you know, something like if you've never heard of like a Google review card, this is something that I think would be beneficial. I'm just going to leave this up and just hop over and show you. This right here is an example. I have no affiliation with this site at all. I was just trying to find an example and picture of sort of a Google review card. Now, there are actually Google review actual cards that you can buy that actually have the tap interface, tap interface on the back of the phone that can open up your website or scan the QR code. So there are those, but I think it's nice if you can at least generate a QR code specifically for this. Now, it could be your business card, you could have cards specifically that your technicians, depending upon who they are, they actually have these cards with a logo, and just to leave a Google review. This is a great leave behind that you could give to a client upon leaving or finishing or servicing a job, where it's a leave behind where now they understand that they can scan this and leave you a Google review. Now, of course, you can always follow up with your reputation management follow-up system for, say, if they, an hour after the appointment, you can have a workflow kick off and deal with sending them a Google review and things like that. And the nice thing about it is that you can actually begin incorporating these type of QR codes into at least your email and potentially even some other areas that I'm going to show you how you can utilize them. But here, if we come back over here, we're just going to take a look. Let's just do the review link first, and then we can come back and do the website afterwards. So we're going to choose one of these two options. We're going to choose the review link. Next, we're going to come over here and actually choose, here's where we have to specify. Do we want a Facebook profile? Like, do we want to send them to the Facebook review, or do we want to send them to Google review? For the most part, it should be Google review. Now, here's the part where I think is a bit awkward. Now, again, this is going to be first generation, but notice that it's asking for the Google URL and it just has google.com. This is where I would think that if you already had the integration with Google My Business, that you would sit back and actually bring that review link that you have built in automatically in your reputation management. Highlevel would automatically bring that in here and populate that here so that you wouldn't have to go get it. But lo and behold, we don't have that. So this is where it does get a little bit annoying, because now it's like you have to go and open up a whole other tab, then go to your reputation area, go to your links and get your Google link, copy it, and then come here and paste it. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave it the way it is for right now, just for demonstration purposes. But moving forward, I found that to be a little bit irritating. But all right, that's a one-time deal. So once you create this, that's enough. But it's just another step that you have to do in order to get the QR code working. Let's just move on. Notice that this preview over here is very similar to the QR code that we saw in the previous reputation management area. So that right there is what you can do, but there are lots of other customization features that you can do here. So right now, instead of leave us, you could just say, leave us a review. That could be your text. You could choose the font, any kind of font you want for that particular text and the color of it. I'm just going to sit back and let's just say, we'll choose red for this. Let's just be crazy. So it does give you some options of customizing colors, which I like. Now, it does also give you the option if you want to have your brand down here, if you want to have your, you know, whatever brand logo or stuff like that, things like that, and then the color of that text, you could change all that here. But I think one of the coolest things they've got is on the next screen. So here's where you can actually start changing the QR code itself and making this look pretty cool. So here for the background color, this is for the color inside the QR code. Now, I'm going to sit back and copy this. I know the hex color for white, but I'm going to sit back and make this background color just some kind of a loud, nasty green color. So I just want to show you that this is what it looks like. When you start looking at the green, it just changes this particular background color here for it. And you may not want a background color. It may be too loud, but I'm just going to come back here and just put white back, because I pretty much prefer it to be nice and cleaner, but I just at least wanted to show you. Now, likewise, the dot colors, we're going to go ahead and just take a look at that. We're going to just choose black. I'm just going to copy this because we're going to change it later. But let's just say we wanted to make that red. Okay. So the dots right here are these things that you see. So you can change those colors. The marked border color. So if you want to have, this is like the color around, I'm going to sit back and just make it a different color, make it like a yellow. So as you see this right here, this little border color, this is what we're changing. So it does give you some cool ways to at least come in. And I've seen features like this and QR codes that you would have to pay for, but this would be like the premium version to go through and customize it and make it look like this and stuff like that. You can't just take the free version. It's very plain and uncustomized. Now, likewise, if you wanted to, you can customize this little color in the center here. And I'm going to come back and just, let's see, what color do we want to do here? Oh, let's do blue. So now we just change this color to blue. Probably not the best, because you really care. Change it to some kind of green. That way it really comes up. But now you see the center color. So you can change the background, these dot colors, the outline border, the center border. You've got a lot of customization here to be able to do that. And you can sit back and actually change some of the shapes. Like, how do you want the dots to be? Now you could change this. I didn't really see a whole lot of changes to the dots here. But the cool thing about it is here, this marked border. So these borders right here, I'm going to blow this up. This little area right here, you can come over here and make it a square if you want. Make it a circle. And notice how that these things change. So that is pretty cool. And then the center part here, if you don't want this little green circle, you can come back and make it a square. So again, pretty cool. And all of this stuff is available inside of Highlevel for sure. So for free. So right now you're going to come here and you can actually put an image here in the center. This is up to you. If you want, you can come here and put in like a Google. If you wanted to and put like this right here would be for Google reviews. If you wanted to, you can, if this is like for a website, then you could use YouTube or WhatsApp or Facebook or something like that. That would be another option, but it's nice that they give you a couple of different your logos that you can use here. Now, right now for the page background, this right here is for if you wanted to have upload an image that goes to the very back. I'm not really going to do that because I could show you. I'll just choose something like if you want to just use this, but notice how you got a little bit of a different look here, but I'm going to go ahead and remove this. You really have to be the image has to be built for this particular review if you want to leave it behind, but it's nice that you can do that. So now that you've got this nice little review right here, they've got a nice little way to just download the QR code, which is nice. So now you can download the QR code. Great. Now what? Okay, now what do we do? So now you can actually take this downloaded QR code, come over here and use this particular site or some other site or Amazon to come here and upload that QR code to a business card, make it look all nice and cute, and generate some cards for your potential client, or they can, as a way for their technicians to have leave behinds. And this could be on the door. This could be, these things could be printed on invoices if you wanted to. Keep in mind, you can add these images and put them on an invoice if you wanted to with a little message over here about leaving us a Google review. So they can be used all over the place. Now, one of the things I did want to sit back and show you is you can also use it inside of Highlevel. So let's go to the media storage and let's go to new upload. And we're going to upload a file and I'm going to come here and upload that QR code that we just spent. So here we've got the QR code inside of our media library and we can have one. Of course, we can come here and just get the link. Now, for those people that have seen some of my other videos, what do you think I'm going to do right now? What do you think I'm going to create? Custom value. That's right. We're going to be creating some custom values here. I'm sorry. I'm just being a little bit silly. But we're going to go through and create a custom value. And this is where we can simply have Google review QR. And of course, if I could type. So right now we can enter the value. We can just simply paste that and just simply click create. Now, when we do this, here's one of the nice things about it is that now if we wanted to, we've got now a custom value that we can put someplace and use in, keep in mind, guys, if you watch some of my other videos, QR codes, you can use them in email templates. You can use them in your marketing templates. You can use them across the board, anywhere on a website. So if you have a particular website that you want to put the leave the QR code image on, you can actually use a custom value. And I just wanted to show you that'd be a cool thing to do if you want to begin utilizing this. So now you have a custom value that if you wanted to, it's always available somewhere and you can always, guess what? You can always come through and update that QR code with another one. So you can have QR codes for seasons. Like if you want to create one for Halloween, or want to create one for Thanksgiving or for Christmas, you can change all of those colors to make them themed and have maybe different images on them depending on the different types of the year, depending upon if you're sending out emails at certain times or not. That might be a fun thing to do and might be interesting for your client to be able to do that. So that's one way we can actually utilize this. So we're going to come back in here, QR codes. And now that we've done that, I'm going to go ahead to QR codes that represent, let's just do our blog site. So we're going to do website now. So here we're going to sit back and I'll just do my site, which is rayodaniel.com. If you haven't visited, there's a lot of good information there. So this right here, again, we don't get, some of the options of Facebook or Google. We just get to put in a URL. But when we go through the next one, all of the other stuff here, the shape, form, logo, all these things are the same. So I'm not going to go over them again for the page background, but it is nice because now you can actually have, you can generate as many QR codes as you want. And here's some of the cool things that you can actually start doing about QR codes. If your clients are doing mailings, okay, this is where if you ever do specials, so if you ever have coupons, if you ever do mailings or emails to people where you want to sit back and say, hey, how about you visit us and we're running a fall special on, gutter cleaning or something like that. I'm just coming up with an example here, but let's just say you wanted to send out something and instead of sending out a big marketing piece, what if you actually wanted to drive them to a funnel page where now they could sit back and sign up for your free offer? Or opt in for the particular free offer and then schedule an appointment directly on your funnel site. Okay. Now I don't have any of that stuff built out on this and I'm just trying to give you some ideas, but if you wanted to, you can have that URL for your offer be a custom subdomain of, of your business or your client's business domains. And you can actually have that configure the domain and then copy that domain and paste it in here for the URL. And now you can email and send people out for the fall special, click here and scan the QR code. That'll take them out to the funnel page, allow them to see what the fall special is online and then use their phone or whatever to sign up or opt in for that particular thing. You can use the QR codes in a variety of different ways. And the fact that I'm just going to say no here. And the fact that you can customize it, make as many as you want. You can save these images. You can upload them into the media library. You can create custom values. You can do some creative things with QR codes. So guys, that's really it. The QR codes really wasn't huge. I just wanted to show you that it is a new feature. You can go ahead and take advantage of it and give you some ideas of how you can begin utilizing this. How can you explain this to your clients? How can they begin utilizing it to just be a little bit different? You know what I mean? Sometimes it's just being different would be enough to get people curiosity and go out and take a look at what you have to offer. Instead of sending them an email, just like, hey, we've got a huge fall special. Scan the QR code and go take a look at our special. How many people will actually go out and take a look at it? That brings back into another different area. How do you track all that? How do you track all the access that people have to different QR codes and who scanned them and so forth? Guess what? If you didn't notice, there is this nice button called Analytics right next to Generate the QR Codes. Let's take a look at that real quick. So if we generate this, what this is going to do, of course, is going to take us into an area that allows us to sit back and track each QR code that scanned. Now, I haven't scanned any here, but right now, if you do look at this, then you can actually just see you'll have different days and you'll have different QR codes scanned. You've got them down here, so you see, and maybe I need to blow this up, but here you've got the review QR code that we created, and you've got, let me move over a little bit here. Over here, you've got total scans. So this right here could be 5 total scans, 10, 15. Okay, so at least you're able to sit back and track if people are actually utilizing the QR code. So if you do have a special and you do email people out and you're emailing them the QR codes, and you can embed the QR code as just an image if you want to inside of your email template for the fall special or offer, you at least can engage how many people clicked on it. So that's pretty cool. So that right there gives you just an option for being able to track all that stuff. And again, the whole point of this is just being able to give you a little bit more analytics to your QR codes to just see if people are really utilizing them. So guys, I hope you found it useful. If you did, give the video. If you're not subscribed, hit the subscribe button on my YouTube channel. I'm really looking to grow this particular channel and I need your help in order to do it. I do release several videos a week. So if you hit subscribe, hit that little bell notification because I come up with all these feature releases, ways of making money with Highlevel. There's no telling what kind of videos I'm going to sit back and create, so you don't want to miss them. Thanks so much for checking in and have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.